take my heart for you.
Uncle to uncle.
Can't take my eyes off you.
Uncle to uncle.
Welcome everybody to Uncle, the first podcast that takes place in a king-size bed where two uncles call each other my brother. I'm your main host, Franklin, and I'm joined by the coolest uncle of my whole world.
Sure.
What's up, Uncle Howard?
Well, I'm coming in cold this one, Franklin. I'm coming in just cool, calm, and collected, brother, because I got my mind off of business. I'm done with that business stuff, my brother. Now I'm getting deep into film Twitter.
You're off Wall Street, and you're now living in the cinema.
Yeah, you know? I'm living in the bright lights, the red carpet, man. Oh, I love it. Hollywood. Oh, that Tinseltown dreams, a million lights on Broadway and a broken heart for everyone. You know what? Film Twitter, they haven't said anything to me since I announced I was taking over.
Yeah, no, I understand. You know, I thought you were going to do a bit of a musical intro, so since you wouldn't. I got this.
Yeah.
My blood runs cold. My memory has just been sold. My uncle is a centerfold. Uncle is a centerfold. Yeah. You're not the only one.
This
who
is
does music.
Story of Lil Unc, who drank a Red Bull and got real drunk. And though he looks so good when he's Darth Maul, you absolutely love him. When he podcasts.
All right. How many days in a year? Woke up with hope and only had fear. Okay.
Yeah.
You know what? Scary.
That's the devil, brother. I haven't lied to you.
Buddy and Maul.
Oh, the devil.
Probably great friends, man.
I was thinking of Joe Buddy just today, man.
Yeah, what point of your day, of your illustrious work day?
Yeah, I was probably, this was the part where I was just standing in the middle of the living room staring for no reason.
Fair enough. I mean, I'm pacing in our bedroom a lot now lately.
Yeah.
You ever pace in your room and just like, you're just not recreate arguments. But you have future arguments, so you're prepared for them. That's what goes on with me sometimes.
Oh, that's right, man. Yeah, you gotta. Well, because nothing's worse than getting, you know, losing an argument because you didn't have a good comeback.
So I try to be prepared. I evaluate. Okay, who do I have beef with at the moment?
Yeah,
and I run through all those scenarios independently. And I try to do much like Doctor Strange. I try to evaluate each of the possible outcomes. It's all about winning.
Yeah. Duh. Winning.
Yeah. Very topical.
Yeah. Very,
you know, we may have listeners who don't know what that is.
Yeah, they weren't even born when it happened.
God. Yeah. Moving on, Uncle
Howard.
That
was like 37 years ago at this point, huh?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. There was a good Funny or Die of Jerry O'Connell making fun of Charlie
Sheen. Oh yeah, Charlie Chainsaw. He was a fearsome competitor.
Yeah, reminded me of Terry Funk.
Yeah, a lot like Terry Funk, but he wore pantyhose on his head.
Pantyhose. He loved the smells.
Yeah. Oh, he got a good whiff.
I love whiffs.
Oh, whiff member.
Do you have anything for me to smell? Gym shorts and a bong?
Why don't you smell all this success? Because everything I see is money.
Okay, bye. Bye, whiff member. The most perverted
of
the gold member family. Yeah. Loves his whiffs. He should go bid on some... Should go put on some worn gear over on wrestling eBay.
Hey, did you see somebody replied to Virtual Pros about the terrible fans? And there was one, this gal made a photoshopped fake Instagram photo of Becky Lynch from the future of her yet to be born baby, and Becky Lynch saying, "Oh, love you fans, couldn't have had my baby without you," or whatever.
Yeah, I saw that. So what happened was, okay, so some fan made a fake Becky Lynch Instagram and he photoshopped her with a baby and was like, "Oh, this is Oliver or something such," you know. Wait, did Becky Lynch, the real Becky Lynch, reply to that fan, or was it just?
I don't think so.
She didn't. So
I hope she didn't see it.
No, I hope so as well. The fan made a he made a Becky Lynch Instagram where she successfully had her child, and she thanked them. It's bizarre, certainly.
It's not acceptable behavior.
It is not acceptable behavior. Well, he's just enthusiastic. Everybody loves a baby. When you're in line at the grocery shop store. Oh,
yeah.
There's a baby behind you or in front of you, and they're just wailing away. That wailing sound is just like, oh, new life. Beautiful. Or on an airplane.
After Kate and Will had their little baby, little Prince George, I know you were sobbing with joy for several days.
That's right. That's right, man.
There's finally a new little prince.
That's right. Those were my words. Exactly that. I knew very well who Kate and George are.
Prince Williams ain't doing
Kate
right
McKinnon and George Foreman.
Because if you was me, I would have married Kate and Ashley.
More Kanye?
Yeah, brother, the only musician that I think you know that you don't.
I know music, motherfucker.
Yeah?
I just don't think anything can beat nature. How about that?
Oh, you know what? The sounds of nature, those beautiful sounds of a little creek burbling over stones.
Yeah, followed by a nice Eddie Van Halen electric guitar. I mean by nature.
Yeah, there's nothing more natural than Eddie wailing on a Fender.
Oh, I love it, man.
Bending those chords all wheely wheely wee. Man, that's cool.
Oh, God. I'm trying to remember something here. Yeah. You're a lot older than I am. We won't dive into that. You're a lot older. So much
7,000 years old. I'm at the highest risk level of coronavirus.
Yes, that I know. But do you remember when people would wear those like Zelgin shirts? It was like a brand for like, you know, it was like a musical brand. It was like Zelgin or something like that.
Yeah, Zelgin. I don't remember
those shirts. You probably own one.
No, but I know about the symbols, brother. Those are the best symbols in the game.
That's like a band.
No, it's a brand of a cymbal. You know, the ting tinkies on the drum set. Not the boom boom boom, but the tinky tinky tink crash. That's cymbal.
Yeah. It's like Zelgin, right?
Yeah, that's cool, man.
Zelgin, yeah. People had those shirts a lot in high school.
Man.
And I had a friend who used to be funny and no longer is funny. It's a tragedy. Me,
someone you used to know.
No, it's not somebody I used to know. It's somebody me, Dennis, and Bert talk about a lot. It's like, oh, wow, he's posting things again.
I know what you're talking about.
You know what we're talking about. So real fucking, behind the scenes shit here. So, but the one funny thing he did once at a mall was like, "Hey, Zildjian, that's the name of your band? That's awesome." It was very funny. It was the tone, not the joke, not the context, people.
It's a good joke, man.
It's a good joke. He did a voice with it. He did a voice that I can't match. I'm not a voice guy.
Zildjian,
right? Yeah.
Yeah. It's a good thing you're not a voice guy, or else you'd always be doing Newt Gunray.
That's right. That's right. This is impossible.
Yeah. It's not offensive to do Newt Gunray voices because there's no Newt Gunrays on Earth to offend.
That's right. Amen, my brother. Amen.
Amen. So why don't you take a stab at it?
So, okay. Okay. What about one of his associates? I was watching some clips of The Phantom Menace.
Yeah, is Newt Gunray one of the guys at the very beginning?
He's at the very beginning, my brother. He makes contact. He may have one of the first lines of dialogue. So the first lines of dialogue might be from the actor who played Ki-Adi Mundi, which is odd because he also played Newt Gunray, but he also played the ship in the introduction shot to a Phantom Menace.
Oh.
And he goes, "We're making contact."
And the ship says that?
Okay, you remember the beginning of Phantom Menace, right? They're on a ship.
Yeah, but the ship itself is speaking? Is it a
The pilot.
Hey, how come
the pilot on the ship says we're making contact?
How come there aren't any just droids that are so big you can fly in them?
Clone Wars has established there are droids that fly around and they'll latch onto them and they'll fly a little bit. You know, they won't fly as high. So he can grab R2-D2 and fly a little bit with his jets.
Yeah, and that's all well and good. But I'm saying, why haven't they ever made a ship-sized droid?
A large-ass droid is what you're saying.
Yeah, like imagine if the Millennium Falcon was a droid.
Well, it has an onboard computer.
Well, why can't the computer sass at you?
Well, it does! Empire Strikes Back, C-3PO. This onboard system has the most peculiar dialect, referencing what's now L3 from Solo. Uncle Howard, I just have to school you all day, huh?
Are you serious? The onboard computer is L3?
Yes.
So it's a real social justice spaceship.
Oh my god! Well, sure. I mean, but it doesn't speak much necessarily. The droids have to interface with it.
We've
lost our whole audience.
No, I think they're just.
I have to school you so much.
No, because you know what? This droid stuff's complex, man. There's ethical considerations.
There are ethical considerations, absolutely.
Are there any droids that they fuck in Star Wars?
Well, L3, once again, did say, it works. You know what I didn't like about Solo? It didn't pass the Bechdel test.
Oh, that's true.
Because even the two female characters that did interact, Kira and L3, they spoke about Lando and Han or whatever. They spoke about guys.
But the guys, who knows what they were speaking about?
But you don't quite understand the Bechdel test, do you?
The Bechamel test.
You would fail it.
Oh, would I?
Yeah, you would fail it.
I would study all night for that Bechdel test, brother. Believe me.
Sure. I'm sure you would. Here,
let's do it right now. I bet I can pass it.
Okay. All right. Go ahead. Here is your test.
Okay.
I'm handing you a form.
All right. Oh, I see that a woman filled out this form.
Yep. That is correct.
I hope she gets this job.
Congratulations. You pass the Bechdel test. Wow. Selfless. Selfless. She'll have the job now as Wall Street's top broker of stocks.
She's just as qualified as anybody.
God. You passed the Bechdel test there.
Oh. That feels good, man. I'm going to put that on my curriculum vitae.
Curriculum vitae. Your resume.
Yeah, my resume. a lot. It's funny. A lot of these kids nowadays, they talk about their Zoom meetings, but all I'm talking about is resume meetings because I'm getting jobs left and right, man. What economy.
It's one of the best right now. It's one of the best in the whole America.
Mm-hmm, the best American economy we could have ever had.
We have the best American economy in the United States right now.
There's no question.
There's no question.
Yeah, I'd like to see you deny that. As far as America has ever been right at this moment, it's the best it could be.
Yeah, I don't disagree with that.
Hey, and we've taken the time stone around, because a lot of people said, you've used the time stone and found this was the best reality we could be living in. But what about now that everything is different and badder And it turns out still best case. Everything's fine.
Everything is fine.
Comparatively.
You know, I kind of want to put the heat on Marvell. I kind of want to put the heat on them and force their hand to release Black Widow.
I want to watch Black Widow so bad.
You want to watch it so bad, huh?
I'm going crazy for a new superhero movie that there are some superhero movies I deliberately haven't watched yet because I save them for emergencies.
Now, see, that's terrible. What movies have you not seen? It's terrible, but you're trying to parcel these out there.
I still haven't, I'm always prepared. I'm a prepper.
Okay.
I still haven't seen, this is to my shame, but I still have not seen Black Panther.
Okay.
I just didn't get around to it. And then after it came out, I felt like they just started releasing a ton of movies all in a row.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they did. They certainly did. I guess you're right there. I mean, okay.
And also, my first exposure to Black Panther and Marvel was in Civil War, and I didn't really like that movie that much. So
Civil War was a bad movie. And seeing Marvel, what they've done is so smart. They release so many movies, so even if they put out a stinker, it doesn't matter because you got the next one.
Yeah, it was really there. Well, it, and of course, Thor... Dark World, save for the cat parts. Cat Dennings parts was a stinker.
You haven't seen Thor 2?
No, I have seen it.
Okay, you have seen it.
Yeah, but it was a stinker. I haven't seen Spider-Man 2 Part 3, the third, second Spider-Man.
Spider-Man 3 Part 2.
Yeah, and I haven't seen Shazam.
That's DC.
Yeah, but I haven't seen it.
Okay. Yeah, Jeff likes that one a lot. I think it's fine. It was fine. I don't really. It didn't resonate with me.
He's a kid.
He flosses.
Yeah, I know. That's cool, man. That is cool.
It's like sleeves.
Dance. Yeah. I heard you're going to do the floss dance on the next stream you do.
No. I already dabbed, and somebody had to save that clip. That was great. You know, they can clip things on that Twitch.
Yeah,
really embarrass you.
I wish they'd clip themselves right into getting a life. You know, they're always harassing you, Franklin. Isn't that the thing? You can't get a moment's peace. People are so obsessed with you. Obsessed with you.
Yeah. You know what Shampoodler did the last stream?
No, I don't even want to know, but tell me anyway.
This is disgusting. We're doing great. Me, Rocco, McCray, and Bert, they were all doing so proud. Like, they are my children. They are my Battlefront children, and they were growing up right before my eyes and improving within each round. Shampoodler, what's that?
You were so proud.
I was proud. Yeah. I was proud. And Shampoodler says, Franklin, check your notifications when you get the chance. So I did, you know.
Yeah.
Right after the game.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, I mean, he said it was important. If somebody tells me something is important, I'm going to take them at their word. Why would they lie?
Yeah.
And then I open it up, and you know what I see? Now, this is a doctored image. This isn't real. It was Yoda, a photo of Yoda, you know, Master Yoda.
Yeah. The Jedi Master. He was on the
Jedi console. Master. He was, you know, a master on the Jedi Council.
Yeah,
the master.
I'd say it's a big freaking deal, okay?
I'd say it's the equivalent of a billionaire playboy philanthropist.
Yeah, not quite, but close.
Okay. And the photo was Yoda.
Yeah.
Having sex with a lamb. He was humping it.
A lamb?
A sheep, a lamb. I don't know the fucking difference, man.
A lamb in sheep's clothing.
My point is, it was disgusting.
Sickening. You know what? Did it shock you?
It did shock me. I haven't been so shocked since 2005 when I went to the Laugh Factory one night. Let me tell you, that factory was not manufacturing laughs that night. Something happened. Something happened with the machinery.
Did you see the picture somebody photoshopped so it looked like it was Joe Biden on the I don't even know what Joe Biden did, but I thought that was a funny picture.
Harpo messaged me, Joe Biden had one bad night.
Man, you know what though? Joe Biden, he needs to get back out among the people. That's where his strength comes from.
He can't be cooped up in there, you know?
No, he's getting stir crazy, man. He's like a POW.
Trow.
Pow. Mia.
Pow Mia. What,
Mama no. Mia. I'm a pow.
I love, like, Pow Mia. I don't know enough, you know, anybody who's a prisoner of war. I mean, that's a rough deal.
Yeah, I ain't trying to get prisoner of war. That's for damn sure.
Yeah, I don't want to be part of that group. I'm not gonna front. That ain't a group I'm trying to join. Stonecutter's okay.
Yeah, but you Palmia. Know what? I'm a coward, so it doesn't seem likely.
Right, me too. As a coward. Oh, you're a coward. You stand for nothing. Yeah, dude, right. And I'll never be a fucking Pow Mia.
Yeah, I'll never get John McCain'd.
Yeah. So why is it like conservatives are like all about that Pow Mia shit? It feels like some like low-key racist shit. All
liberals don't give a shit about these guys.
And like Dolph Ziggler has them on their tights. I feel like, you know, conservatives talk, I don't try to be Jack here, but you know, the whole concept of virtue signaling. Patriotism in itself is fucking virtue signaling, because who gives a fuck about where you live? Like, okay, well, that's just your circumstance, man. Like, whatever, dude. Like,
yeah, well, but Franklin, now this is where you're getting things wrong. First of all, you think about all our freedoms we got, care of the U.S. nice government. Now, I don't love the government, but that flag. Now, there are a lot of good men died for this country, first and foremost. If you don't like that punk, you get out of here. Now, I drive a Chevy. Yes, I do drink Coors beer. And as a matter of fact, I have broken both of my ankles twice.
Well, very sorry to hear that, Uncle Howard. You broke your ankles on the basketball court.
That's right, breaking ankles, son. So,
no, you broke your ankles trying to guard Steph Curry.
Yeah, I was trying to post up against Steph Curry.
And yeah.
He literally broke my ankles. He hit me so hard that my ankles
broke. He assaulted you, my brother.
And that's why I said, I can't do basketball anymore. I got to find a new cause, and that's freeing the Pow Mias.
You know what happened? Before the NBA season started, last NBA season, not this current one, I said, I hope the Golden State Warriors have a series of entries akin to Mr. Burns' softball team. And motherfucker, they did. And I feel terrible.
Yeah, look at that.
I was joking. I don't want Boogie. Yeah. You think I want Boogie Cousins mad at me?
Yeah, you got that terrible power inside of you.
Gosh. Well, wish I could predict lucky number 11.
Yeah.
I should bring that up. That's my movie.
That's a good one, lucky man. Hartnett.
You know, Josh Hartnett, you thought that would be like, oh, okay, this is his tour de force. Like, this is him, and now he's going to be a big deal. Yeah. I remember in a film class I took once, we got a clip from this movie, and the teacher was just like, you know what? This is pretty good. He's like, you know what? This is pretty good. Let's just watch the whole thing. And he's just like, and we watched Lucky Number 11.
Hey, that's not a bad movie. It's got Morgan Freeman in there and the Mandarin from Iron Man 3.
You love that Mandarin, Ben Kingsley.
Yeah.
There was a scene there. I don't know if it was. Is Bruce Willis in this movie? Yeah, he's in this. When he talks about something like, oh, it's like an Omaha switch and such. Like,
yeah, I love that.
You know what I'm talking about. Like the beginning. Yeah, and that's what I remember. I remember it went to the Greyhound track in that.
Yeah,
that's pretty good.
There's some crime in this movie.
There's crime. I think there's a casino.
Yeah, there's a Jewish guy. I think Ben Kingsley's a Jewish guy.
There you go. I mean,
his character's named like the Jewish guy or something.
Oh, okay. Bruce Willis. You want to know why this is such a great performance by Bruce Willis?
Is he bald?
Because he played somebody with hair.
What?
He played somebody like a regular person, like you or me, with a full head of hair.
That is crazy. Ben Kingsley plays the rabbi. But you want to know what's cool?
Morgan... you just called the Jewish guy.
Well,
he plays a character called the Jewish guy.
please find for me one rabbi who's not Jewish.
Damn. Chess mate, man. Didn't the king you now?
Yeah. Hey, you're playing 21, brother. Guess what I'm playing.
Okay. What are you playing?
22.
Oh, fuck.
Now, lost. Morgan Freeman plays a character named The Boss.
Nice. Sasha Banks.
Yeah, the legit boss. Mm-hmm. And of course, Lucy Liu plays Lindsay.
Yeah. The very supportive girlfriend.
Well, Lucy Liu is so cool, man.
She's chill. I like her. She's great in Futurama.
I bet she'd like our show. More than anybody else who was in Kill Bill.
Yeah. She would definitely like our show more than any other Kill Bill alumni. I don't think Quentin would like our show at all because we made fun of him a few times.
Yeah, he'd be like, what's the big deal? Hey, okay, I like feet. Okay, I get it. Fine. You're smart guys. You're funny guys.
No, he would say, oh, it's this Uncle Howard's satirical take on the privileged class there that get off on their own. I don't know. I can't even pretend to sound smart.
He's just a jerk, man. A jerk.
He showed up to the Beavis and Butthead premiere in board shorts.
Like a bum.
You go to the red carpet and you dress like a bum?
Yeah, come on, man. At least get a little Ben Foster frosted tips up in there.
Yeah, eyes wide shut, my brother.
Oh, Ben Foster, that's a cool guy.
Man, Ben Foster, dude. Ben Foster the People is my favorite band. Those Pumped Up Kicks.
My favorite band's Ben Foster 5.
Yeah, they sing the Come on, Cinderella.
What a good show we have.
Yeah.
We're back.
We're back. I saw that song being used in the Pete Davidson Judge Apatow movie.
Pete Davidson, that's a guy I'd rather not see again.
I love writing a good Harvey Davidson, but Pete, no thank you.
Yeah, that's not my kind of ride, brother.
What's your movie, man?
Well, Franklin, I believe we've all seen one film in particular. It stars a beautiful Oscar award-winning actress by the name of Jennifer Lawrence. She's really kind of coming into question about what it means to be part of a family. She has undergone some terrible loss. She's learned that she can't trust maybe even her own mind at this point.
Suffers from some mental illness, maybe?
She might suffer from mental illness. We don't know. But it seems like, you know, the kind of person that she is, she's one person one moment and another person another. Mm. Yeah, just very unstable. So you can probably guess what movie this is.
Easy. That's Silver Linings Playbook with Brad Cooper, De Niro, and, of course, the esteemed Julia Stiles.
Whoa, my brother, you better style yourself something other than a movie expert, because what I picked is 2019's X-Men Dark.
I saw this shit in theaters, man.
Yeah, now this is a good movie, man.
No.
What? Mm-mm. Okay. What did you like? I'll tell you everything I didn't like about this movie real quick, because there's not a lot to it. One, Professor X is still bald. That's dumb.
Okay. What else? Is that it?
It's implied that a dog dies, which I don't like that much.
I don't like that. We are anti. I tried watching Game of Thrones. Third episode, they kill a wolf dog. I said, nope.
Game of Thrones.
Benioff and Weiss. You're a singular bad director, Benioff and Weiss.
Hey, it's Benioff and Weiss.
Fuck you. You want to kill a dog just for some sympathy for your Lord of the Rings incestual hour on HBO? Pass.
The only reason you should kill a dog is to absorb its power. Now, this movie is really good. That's why Mike Vick was such a good football player for so many years. Now, this is a great movie. This movie is about space forces that come to get you. Now, frankly, a lot of times, you know, a movie, there's a SOS signal, right? Oh, they need to save somebody, and it's boring. They're just stuck in a river, or their plane is crashing. You've seen it a million times.
Saw it, yeah, Sully.
Yeah, Sully Sullenberger. Hey, sorry, Sullenberger, because you're old garbage. This movie is cool, man. What they go to investigate is a U.S. space shuttle that's spinning around. And wow. Hey, why is it spinning around? Because of space forces.
Maybe now, Dormammu passed them by.
Yeah, Dormammu said, she keeps on passing me by.
Deadpool's going to have, Deadpool fucks with those X-Men a lot.
Yeah, Deadpool really, he's pushing his luck, and he better watch it, because if Quicksilver's in there, he's going to run all over him like an old rug in the hallway.
You know, I once got into an argument with somebody online about, because they were saying, I don't know, they're saying some stupid shit. I don't even recall, to be honest. Maybe it was something like, I don't know, maybe they were saying some real homophobic shit, and they had a Deadpool avatar. And I said, you know, Deadpool gets he gets pegged in the movie and enjoys it, you know, which is awesome, because who doesn't want to get pegged? And this guy's like, actually, Deadpool didn't like that. So nice try.
don't
try to retcon Deadpool's pegging. Deadpool loved to get pegged. Who doesn't, my brother? It's fantastic.
He hid the wedding ring up his ass.
for Christ's sake. He wanted to have a baby that way.
Yeah.
He wanted to have a baby that way in Deadpool 2.
You know what the thing about Deadpool is? He's a real sick motherfucker, guy. You know? you think
I've seen his shirts.
Yeah, you think, oh, Facebook. This guy, he doesn't like to have things up his butt. This guy likes everything. He's crazy. Deadpool's so crazy, dude. You don't even know what he's going to do next. He's going to make like some joke about dead babies or something. He's so crazy. He'll probably do like a Robin Williams impersonation or something.
Deadpool was made for like middle schoolers, essentially. Yeah. That's Deadpool. One audience Deadpool was made for.
Cool as hell.
Was made exclusively for like edgy middle schoolers.
I laughed harder at one joke in Deadpool 2 in the theater than anybody else did I was just something like Deadpool just was said something like, oh, foreigners don't know about religion or something like that. And I just
much like your commentary on Lucky Number 11's The Rabbi. I think he played the Jewish guy. That was his actual name. No.
Hey, you know what? You're right. Not every Jewish guy's a rabbi, but every rabbi's a Jewish guy. And that's an Uncle Howard promise.
That's a pillow promise.
That's a pillow promise, brother. Now, we talked a little bit about this movie before. We talked about how much you love the Quicksilver scene.
I love that Quicksilver shows up for like 3 minutes. And they can't. He's like, he gets injured and that's it. Oh. We're going to get, who are we bringing to this battle? Oh, we'll bring this X-Men, this one, and this one. What about Quicksilver? Oh, no. He's still hurt from that first awesome scene 30 minutes ago.
Early scenes, you see how badass he is.
Yeah,
and you're awesome. Like, oh, this guy's real badass. And then at the end, when he starts to do something badass and the bad guy instantly takes him out, you realize, whoa, this bad guy is a serious dude. Or dudette. In this
validate
film.
That's true. Wow. Hey yeah. It's that, there's a powerful line from J-Law.
Yeah,
she says, hey, you know, Gene saved us last time, I'm saving your ass this time. Why the hell do we call this group the X-Men when the women are doing all the work?
Yeah,
that got a pop for me in the theater. I went, yeah.
Right, and you know what? That's funny, because the bald guy, he's a real jerk in this movie.
I hate to use this word, because
he's like
the right of try to hijack it. He's a cuck.
Yeah, you think he's a cuck to his own fame.
He's a cuck to his own. Yeah, and I did have to admit there was one scene where he was walking. And that was a little funny.
Oh yeah, she makes him walk with her.
She makes him walk. He's like, no, I don't want to do this.
Why isn't he happy? He's like, finally, I'm walking again.
Finally, right?
Damn, this is tight.
Like, I missed the fuck out of this.
Can you turn me around and walk me down to Panda Express?
Take me across the street.
I order you right now, Gene.
Where is Wolverine?
Wolverine, he's still in the future in this movie. Now, there's another interesting thing about this movie. This movie takes place in 1992. This movie is in the same X-Men continuity as the Bryan Singer, and that's a great director. I wonder what he's been up to lately.
I don't know.
The Bryan Singer X-Men, which came out in the year 2000, which means in the intervening 8 years, Michael Fassbender turns into Ian McClellan.
He goes from a hunk to a fucking dud. Oh my god.
Ian McKellen is a hunk for an old guy. Don't call him a dud, man. That's not nice.
Compared to Michael Fassbender?
Yeah, Fassbender apparently has a big wang, too.
You think he's got a big dick? He probably has a big dick. I feel like he's the kind of guy who wears sweatpants. He wears sweatpants to show the outline.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's like, no,
I don't know. I bet he's like a British. I bet he's undercover British. He's like, oh, I don't know what you're talking about. The outline of the penis. I'm
Googling Michael Fassbender penis. There's an article called A Year in the Life of Michael Fassbender's Penis. Here's an article called What Does Michael Fassbender's Penis Look Like?
Oh, I bet greasy.
Here's a hot take. Michael Fassbender says discussing his penis is sexist.
Man, the nerve of men. Men can't put up with the same shit, the same exploitation that women put up with here. This man, Michael Fassbender, we are allowed to talk about. We're allowed to speculate about your penis.
I'm looking. I found a Tumblr. It's called Fassbender's Penis Appeared and .com, and it's just a lot of pictures of him wearing jeans. Or now that can't be real because no one's penis could outpower
penetrate denim. Penis.
Yeah, no, denim is one of the most powerful substances there's ever been.
All right, I found something from a forum we frequent on Uncle to Uncle, the bodybuilding forum. Oh, is Michael Fassbender skinny in your opinion? This is from 2018. 2014, is Michael Fassbender good looking? I'm really confused right now. Okay. Well, vaya con Dios, man. Yeah, he's good looking. No shit. I hope in 8 years he's not looking like freaking original Magneto. Yeah.
His dick.
Okay.
Oh, holy shit, man. Is that really his dick?
We can't talk about. Okay, look. Yeah, look, original poster. So this is 2018. Original poster. You are obsessed with Michael Fassbender. What is wrong with you right now?
Yo, I'm
somebody. Like... I'm sorry to interrupt. This is a good joke. I'm sorry.
Okay.
10 pounds of Michael Fassbender's weight is his dick.
It's true. Look what I just posted, man. That shit's crazy.
Okay. Hold on. I don't know why you. Okay, what's going on here? Is it a GIF?
Yeah. It's
you put a
GIF.
V at the end, so it doesn't open, dude.
I didn't put that there. That's just in it.
Okay. You want me to, I can't open. What's this link? Did you know it's gonna slow down my computer?
Okay, fine. It's just a GIF of him walking and his dick be dangling down.
I wanted to see this. It's just.
Mid thigh, brother.
If you would have saved it and just posted in the Discord, it would be all right.
Oh, man, I'll do that then. Don't worry, I got you.
Okay, don't have to do that. Okay, moving on. Let's move on here.
This is important. This is unbelievable.
We wanted to do an hour. I don't see that happening.
Where are we now?
Where are we now? We're about 20 minutes from an hour right now. We're not getting through all those questions that quickly.
This is folks, this is our third attempt at recording a show. We've had
this is our third attempt. This is fucking Friday night, people.
Yeah, so this we might sucks. You know what? We might not get through all the questions, or we're gonna
I disagree. Nope.
Okay, we're gonna do.
I want to do right by the people. They ask those questions.
Automatic for the people, like REM. All right, here's the first questions from these wacky foreign gals, Homestain, Fringa, and Laddle. I think they've been threatening us. They know where we live, and they're mailing us dried up old frogs. So I think we might have to let them on the show soon. What do you think?
We might be forced to let them on the show.
They seem to know our futures before they've even happened, which is frightening.
It's a bit unsettling, yes.
And they say, why do you cry nightly?
Wow, that's one. That's an invasion of privacy, so I don't have to answer that. And I don't cry every night. Sometimes I go to sleep and I forget the anguish that I live through.
Yeah, some nights, I mean, I just kind of get choked up.
Yeah, and also, Uncle Howard was only crying last night because he saw Revenge of the Sith.
So. Yeah, oh, and that made me so sad. Oh,
you hate seeing that guy get so weak.
Yeah, he got so weak. Oh, it broke me in my heart, that poor fella.
That poor old man.
Oh, I'm too weak. And then Mace Windu gets thrown out of Mace Windu.
Marty Jannetty style.
Marty Jannetty style, right through that barbershop.
Hey, I've heard Marty Jannetty on our show. Sorry.
I was just going to do the 50 Cent song, See You in the Candy Shop.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Yeah, that's good. I know 50.
Yeah, 50 Cent.
50 Cent. What the fuck, dude?
50 Cent. So that's why we cry, because of that poor little man. He got so weak. Oh, and then Anakin, he turns evil, and it makes his friend so sad, because he's like, you were my brother.
That's yeah, weird. It makes his friend sad. It makes his wife sad.
His wife's so sad, she dies.
Broken heart, man. Just like many, many people.
Just like Brutus the Barber Beefcake almost died from. He said it.
He said, oh, Kogan, you broke my heart.
He said it when he came back to Monday Night Raw, and he said, first my wife died or something, and I almost died myself.
Brutus Beefcake did not fucking say that on Raw.
I don't know if his wife, something made him sad, and he said, and I almost died half from sorrow and half from a broken heart. And
Teach once posted a photo of Brutus
I was in a parasailing accident.
That was WrestleMania 9, yeah.
Yeah, he got his face broken in the parasailing accident, and he had to wear this dumb mask.
Dumbass mask. Teach sent me a great photo once of Brutus Beefcake's butt.
Oh, I'd love to see
it. It was during his wedding. It was just a wedding photo, and he had like a tux top, but then the bottom, his butt was exposed.
That's cool. I'm looking at his mask. That was cool.
Oh, stupid ass mask. Him and the fuck out of here.
Hulkster teaming up with that mask on. He looked cool. Hulkster looked great. That was
that black eye.
Yeah. That was right around the time they ran afoul of the villainous Yokozuna.
Yeah. Yeah. And they cucked Bret Hart. Moving on. The next question, Uncle Howard, I'm sure you would love to read it.
Yeah, hey, this is from Head and Arm Choke. He says, who would win in a fight, Howard or Gene Simmons?
Gene, you're free.
He's scary.
He is scary.
Yeah, he's like
you have legitimate credentials that I cannot lie about, Uncle Howard. And yeah, but you would fucking wreck him.
No, he's got those big boots. If he kicked me in the head with those, it'd be good night, Howard.
Look, I'm not going to say you could beat up the Warlord in a fight.
No.
But Gene Simmons, you want to know something about Gene Simmons? I have a hunch.
I know. He's a Jewish guy, so he might be a rabbi.
No, not that. I have a hunch that Gene Simmons is an undercover cuck.
You think
so? I don't have the proof.
Yeah,
I think he's an undercover cuck.
Well, you show us the receipts and I'll listen to you. But until then...
The receipts, it's called a hunch. You never had a hunch before?
I never have and I never will, brother.
Okay, well, you know, just put the pieces together of the statements he makes. And, pieces together.
You got to respect that about me.
That you never had a hunch?
Yeah, you got to respect that.
No, I don't have to respect that.
You don't have to like it, but you do have to respect it.
No, I disagree. Next question. Hold on. I'm clicking here. I got it. Relax.
Hey, you know that movie Mulan and that movie Moulin Rouge? They should make Moulin Rouge.
I'm glad you got down one of the jokes you wrote. That's good.
I didn't write that down. That was off the dome, brother.
Wow. Look at this. A humble brag for that, for Moulin Rouge.
Yeah, something tells me that even though UCB might be gone, improvised comedy might just live on.
Remember when you had the idea to do guerrilla comedy? Stick it to UCB?
Yeah.
How great would it be to, that would have been great to do free comedy outside.
Oh, man. Yeah. We're giving it away.
We're giving it away for free out here. That's such a sick idea, dude. Oh, my God.
Something tells me that if you're just waiting in line to go see a comedy show at UCB, you're already getting a lot of free comedy. How funny must those fans be?
Oh man, I bet.
Just as funny as our own.
Yeah. Oh, for sure. I went to a UCB show. I actually went to the. I kept telling everybody, "Oh, UCB Franklin." Well, my name's Franklin, and they go, "Oh, that's just." They would just go, "Oh."
They didn't say like have some money.
They didn't say have some money. They didn't say, "Oh, the founder." They didn't have anything. They didn't have, you know. I thought improv was you riff.
Yeah, they didn't confuse you with Amy Poehler.
No, they didn't say, "Oh, thank the maker," like C-3PO.
Yeah, C-3PO's maker was God. When you think about it,
it was the Phantom Menace,
the Elaine Bennis.
the Bugman album is called The Phantom Menace.
Yes, I know this.
Probably. You know that? I didn't know you know that. You know who does the introduction on that? It's so good.
Oh, I know who does it.
Who?
I don't know when I say the name of.
Oh, fuck you.
They always say only mention the name of menu fear or menu respect.
Okay, then say my name.
Hey, Franklin. Oh, shit.
Okay. Got him.
Damn.
Next question comes from Bert. He's saying, with the not-so-great state of Florida opening up restaurants at 50% capacity this week, which buffet bar are you guys most excited to hit up first?
Chuck E. Cheese, brother.
Man, you heard the controversy of Chuck E. Cheese? To like five different places on Postmates they can get all this business.
You're like, oh, I'm getting Cavallaro's pizza. And then it just turns out Cavallaro is the name of one of the puppets.
That's right, my brother.
Who are all the people who are thinking, oh, I've never even heard of Cavallaro's before? Well, I'll order their pizza.
Yeah. Oh, Gino's. Yeah. Gino's the raccoon keyboard player, actually. So.
Oh, Cavallaro, that sassy little banjo playing possum.
Oh, you know what? I'm feeling like a slice of a Gino's today. And the slice of the chinos. Now the question is, how did somebody know what Chuck E. Cheese pizza tasted like to be able to identify that?
So do you think the boxes were actually of the new name?
No.
Or were they just Chuck E. Cheese boxes still?
No, I don't think they were Chuck E. Cheese boxes. But there seems to be like that like basic box of like, oh, here's a couple of, you know, stereotypes and a pizza oven type thing, you know?
Yeah.
So, like, I think that was the case here. So maybe they, you know, if they use different boxes for Cavallaro's or a Gino's or, you know, a Sansucci, you know, you know, maybe they deserve a little bit of credit then. If they went the extra mile to make sure, hey, use the Gino's box for that one. Okay,
yeah,
they deserve some credit then. I mean, if you're going through those, I always say if you're going to great extents to break the law, then you are above it.
Yeah. Oh, I agree with you 100%. You've got to respect hard work, regardless of how legal that work is.
That's why I respect Lori Loughlin.
Mm-hmm. She loves to put the work in.
She loves a good education.
Hey, she put family first, and where I come from, that's no crime. That's
amen.
What Dom Toretto does.
Wow. We celebrate, you know, more misogyny before your eyes.
Yeah.
We talk about the X-Men getting all the credit instead of the X-Women.
Mm-hmm.
We talk about L3 and the crusade she led. And now we're talking about Lori putting her family's education first. And she gets 2 months in the slammer. Toretto's never served a day in his life.
You know, if you lived in the X-Men world, that's the only place where you're not actually racist. If you say, I don't care if you're white, black, brown, blue.
Yeah. I know a guy named Scott who would love that.
Yeah. That's one of the great racist lines. I don't care if you're one of the things that doesn't exist, so it doesn't.
Yeah, that's... What a Hall of Fame racist ass line that shit is.
You know what? If Beast and Nightcrawler existed, I wouldn't be racist against them. Let's transport you into an alternate reality where they do exist. Let's put that to the test, pal, because I don't think you're going to pass.
Yeah, I don't think they would pass. I think Kelsey Grammer would fuck them up, actually.
Oh, yeah, he'd be like, wow. Because he's a beast.
He's the beast, man.
He's reading a book hanging on the ceiling, man. That's cool, dude.
When people say beast mode, I'm like, hell yeah. Frasier, baby.
Yeah, that's the only beast mode that I go in.
Next question. Oh, we're almost at an hour.
All right, well, let's cruise on through.
No. It is what it is.
Oh, yeah.
John says, hey, guys. I shouldn't even read that. John, you're disrespecting the sanctity of the question section.
Hey, John. How you do?
Don't do that. Virtual Pros.
Ugh.
They're doing a shame cup. Go listen to the Virtual Pros. They're the best. They're the only wrestling podcast not by wrestlers that I will ever listen to in my life.
They're the only
Are you mad at that plug?
No, I'm not at all, man. Why would I listen to another podcast by someone who isn't a wrestler?
Yeah, right. Really. It makes no fucking sense. It makes no sense. But Virtual Pros, they say, I actually have a question for once. See, that's demeaning.
Yeah, demeaning of life. Got them. Wait, no. Shit.
No. Franklin, what Family Guy character do you see yourself as? What family character do you see Howard has? Howard, same question.
All right.
You want to go first?
Yeah, I see myself as a Stewie. I'm cool. I'm calculating. I'm always up to something. And you better believe my best friend's a dog. I see little Franklin, you're a bit of a Chris, aren't you?
No.
A little bit of a Chris.
Mm-mm, nope.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know you ain't no Meg, brother.
Ah, yeah, Mila Kunis. That's right. I would say, you're dumb as hell.
No.
And you're
cool, handsome,
gelatinous as shit.
What?
You would be the family man himself, Peter Griffin.
Oh, the fam. Well, that's the guy who's getting all the checks. I ain't mad. The titular role.
What do I see myself as in the Family Guy universe? Well, gosh, well, that, I guess if I'm very supportive of your buffoonery, I would in fact be Cleveland. Because I often go and say, that's nasty.
Hey there, Peter.
Who's that?
That was Cleveland.
That's not Cleveland. He goes, hey. Oh, no. Hey. No. Stop that.
No, it's me, Cleveland.
That's not Cleveland, motherfucker. Cleveland goes, oh, no, that's nasty.
Oh, no, that's nasty.
That's not, stop it. You can't do Cleveland. You can't do Cleveland as good as Loretta.
You know what? I shouldn't even try to do Cleveland. That's offensive.
Yeah, we're probably, I don't think either of us should be doing Cleveland right now. I avoided New Gunray, but fuck, I stepped right into this one, man.
Yeah. man.
Oh boy, you got me. Gotcha. Got me to do Cleveland.
Gotcha journalism.
God.
Gotcha move. Great wrestling. Check it out.
Gotcha move. The fucking company that put virtual pros out of business.
Yeah, and business is the one thing we know. Here's a question. This is from Cy Fury. He says, so during quarantine, I've discovered I really like terrible shows on Discovery Channel. Every time I watch Bering Sea Gold, they say, gold, 10,000 times. I think of you and gold, member. You guys have any guilty pleasure TV shows?
Man, I've seen The Pawn Stars. Yeah. And I've seen Storage Wars Canada. There was a ventriloquist on there once. I hated Gross. That damn thing.
Yeah, I know that guy.
Yeah. I did not care for it.
Jeff Dunham.
What's up?
Jeff Dunham.
It wasn't Jeff Dunham.
Very he introduced nice guy.
Jeff Dunham introduced a new character recently.
Oh, boy.
And it was a guy that texts a lot. He's like, it's like a mod. It's like, oh, he's modern. Like, how do you feel about Jose Jalapeno? Is that racist?
Yeah, no, nor is Ahmed the dead terrorist. I bet Jeff Dunham has some real good things to say about coronavirus.
It's just a freaking flu.
Man, I fucking hate that guy. Man.
He did a video, and I swear to God,
video in 30 Rock of all people.
I know, right? He did a video that got like 5 million views, and honestly, it was just his puppets reading like all the memes already. He's like, why are people so upset about toilet paper right now? You know, I mean, just use the freaking hose. That's the old geezer character.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one, too.
You love that one. That's the exception.
He's got so much good stuff. Got like, you know, I might not always be a fan of his, but I just respect his creativity is unparalleled. I mean, he's so racist. That's cool.
What an exceptionally racist man.
You know what? It's not, well, I was going to say it's not popular to be racist anymore, but I guess that's not true. So... You know what? I can't even say he's brave because he's just going along with consensus.
Yeah, that's not even brave anymore. Get the fuck out of here, man.
We used to admire a brave racist, but now we see the racists are just cowards.
They're just, you know.
And we have a trademark on cowardice.
Yeah. That's for us only, motherfucker. All right. Next question.
Yeah.
I got one from Eli Hodap here, and he's saying I'm a complete idiot. Can we confirm that?
Yeah, I think that's science has known that for a while.
And don't seem to be getting any smarter by listening to this podcast.
That's your problem.
That's his problem, right? Even though most of the show is answering questions, what gives?
Well, our fans are dumb. That's an issue. So the questions are always dumb. You know, our only smart fan ever was my son, who would ask us about Venezuela, but he seems to have found better things to do. So we don't get the smart questions like we used to. And by the way, trust us, Venezuela, we're keeping an eye on it.
I got my eye on it. And Eli, what you're asking here is what gives, that why haven't you gotten any smarter? Well, it's a poor carpenter that blames his tools. Okay. I can give you a book that defines every word.
Yeah.
No such book has ever been invented, but say a hypothetical book that told you the definition of every word in the whole, you know, English language.
Yeah. Which you would still discovering.
Yeah. You wouldn't be any smarter after reading that whole damn book. No. So it's not our fault.
Yeah, it's we're a lot like Matt Damon in Good Will Hunting because it's not our fault. Now, it might be your fault for failing to learn properly, but that's okay. That's just what happens to you. Let's see. It looks like Franklin has suffered in illness or difficulty, but no big deal.
No, I'm here. I'm here. I muted myself because I was coughing a lot.
Oh, brother, that makes me sad to hear.
I mean, you know, because you're right next to me, but yeah.
Yeah, well, and it doesn't pick up because I've got noise-canceling headphones. Mm,
that's true. That's true.
Yeah.
Noise, one of the first things to get canceled in 2020.
Yeah, noise is canceled party. Here's a question from Yingling. He says, Franklin, did you like my mustache when I popped into the ill-fated Bosk Zoom meeting?
That was
bad. So far, it's on par with Lalo Salamanders.
Salamanca. And look, that, you know, first off, when I saw Yingling, I'm like, hell yeah, that's a good-ass mustache. And then what happened next shocked me. That was bad. That Bosk, I mean, who knew letting 20 people in at the same time with iPhone 8 as their username would be a bad idea?
Where did they come from?
I don't know. Where did they go?
Where did they come from?
I don't know. Cotton Eye Joe.
Yeah.
Honestly, I mean, I do apologize. I mean, you know, we posted a Zoom link out there. The link wasn't even up for more than like 10 minutes. And people did some horrendous shit. The last thing I saw was somebody, they did a share screen and they shared a photo of the Ice Age main character hanging himself, and it was terrible. It was terrible. I'm like, this is the most graphic. This is the worst thing I've seen.
There's a darkness to the mind that created that piece of art.
It's a sick mind.
Yeah, that's a sick. What a sick. How could they do that to the crudes?
Yeah, I didn't like that, man. We tried to do something innocent and nice and illegally stream the finale of Clone Wars.
And you know what? It looks like from now on, no more Mr. Nice Guy.
No.
You know what? So next Zoom stream we do, we're going to be trolling it. They won't even know what to do. It's already
I'm going to post. I told everybody in the Bosk chat, I'm gonna air an episode of MASH to get them back. I'm gonna have a link there. I'm gonna say, hey, everybody, pop on in. We got Clone Wars. We're back. You know, tell your friends. And then they come in. And they're not allowed to share screen anymore, Harpo. And they're forced to watch MASH.
It would be cool if you could trap people in a zoo.
They can't turn their computers off or do nothing. It's just
forced to watch it.
That's terrible. Wouldn't wish that on my worst enemy.
Well, you would, because these guys are your worst enemy.
They are my worst enemy, and I will. We're going to do it again, goddammit. We're going to do it again, and we're going to air them some MASH.
It's no surprise to me. I am my own worst enemy.
Great band.
Yeah, Lit.
All right. So, Uncle Howard, what's the next question here?
All right. Let's get down with the sickness. Here's a question from Dick Killjoy from the Mighty Mighty Dune Boys podcast. He says... Ever slam your fingers in a car door?
Have I ever? Somebody once closed the car door on my fingers. We're doing some dumb pranks, just, you know, bullshit, as you know.
Yeah.
Back in high school.
Prankster.
I don't know what. Yeah, prankster stuff. Just jackass nonsense. And man, I guess they were throwing out a toilet. It was in their front yard, I guess, waiting for pickup. And I'm like, hey, guys, it'd be epic if I pissed in that toilet.
It would.
I pissed in that toilet. And then a car was coming. I'm like, oh, shit. They're like, Franklin, hurry up. And I'm like, oh, I still got a lot more piss left in my balls, man. So I rushed back in. You know, I didn't piss too much on my pants. And some dork slammed the fucking door on them.
On your sucked. Pants.
You slammed a door on my hand.
Oh, my brother, I'm so sorry to hear about that.
Yeah, it was terrible.
I once accidentally closed a door on somebody else's hand because I was in some car where they didn't understand the doors closed backwards style. And closed the door and it closed backwards onto the guy's hand, and I felt real bad about it.
Oh boy.
Also today, speaking of car doors, I saw some guy who had a Tesla, and this lady apparently had never seen one before, and she was asking him questions about it. When I walked by, she said, "So are these things electric?"
Are they?
Yeah, it's like their main thing.
Oh, I don't know. I don't. Oh yeah, they are their main thing, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not a car guy. I don't give a fuck. Yeah, I know it's their main thing. I only know that because Seth Rollins bragged about his Tesla.
If you cared enough about a Tesla to ask somebody about their Tesla, I think you would know that it's electric.
You would know that. Right. Yeah.
You know,
that's
it's not
their main thing, huh?
I don't know that much about cars, but I would never go up to Sony and go, "What is this, Gallo 24?
24, man. That's brutal on your engine. You want a Gallo 12.
Yeah, Gallo 24 is a little much. I mean,
it's a little much. Yeah.
Boy,
yeah.
You'll be able to turn it up in the stretches, but boy, the maintenance is going to kill you.
There are some great Gallo 24 memes, actually. Please look those up sometime.
I will, man. I love memes now. That's nice.
Yeah, you love memes. That's good.
I love memes. Here's a question from Alphabet Pizza _. She says, "What farm animal do you most identify with?"
Easy.
Right. Yeah.
We're like cows, essentially, man.
Yeah.
We don't get slaughtered at the end. It's terrible. We're like cows. We're just kind of chilling, right? Eating shit.
I'm a little piggy.
You're rolling around in your own filth.
I'm rolling around in a big sty. I'm eating slop. Oh, I'm a little I'm a filthy little piggy.
She made a comment on our Instagram recently.
What about something?
She says, "Look at that. I posted a photo of all the rain and Bud Light Salters."
Oh, yeah. That was cool.
That was cool, right? She said, "Look, it's leaking." I said, "That's not leaking. That was from Uncle Howard's accident earlier in the day."
Yeah, and it wasn't an accident because it was on purpose.
Yeah. Wow. So.
So take that out. A bit pizza. Who's the loser now?
Yeah, who's the loser now? The guy who pisses in bed intentionally, or
I wanted to see what happened.
Yeah, nothing. It just dries up, and that's it. It's like it never existed. Now,
yeah, it's fine. It just goes,
soaks back down to the ground.
Yeah,
and then it evaporates.
I wanted to prove to Franklin. I said, "Listen, I can pee in the bed." You said, "No, I don't think you can." I said, "Watch what happens." Just like the E Network and or Bravo. I don't know. And then I did. And you said, "By God, it just soaks up. And now neither of us have to get up."
It's like a ShamWow.
Yeah. In the middle of the night, I'm sitting in my bed. So that's all good. And I guess that answers her question.
Would you rather have a stranger piss in your bed or somebody you know and love? Come on.
Hey, if you're not sleeping in your own loved one's piss, are you sleeping at all?
Damn. All right. Next question comes from Rocco. Rocco did a great job on my stream. Do you think I'm saying these complimentary things to McCray, Rocco, and Bert as a way to make you step up and motivate yourself to become the player I know you can be?
I hope not, because it ain't working, Bob.
Yeah, it ain't gonna happen, huh? Fair enough.
Yeah, gotcha.
What's a superstition? Sorry.
Oh, great album, Santana.
What's a superstition you still believe in? Brother, I don't believe in any of those things, man. I walk under ladders like Razor Ramon at WrestleMania 10 when he won the Intercontinental title, so it couldn't have been bad luck. You know, I don't know a lot of superstitions.
He's got to be your favorite Cuban, huh?
Why would he be my favorite Cuban?
Well, because he's such a Cuban hero, Razor Ramon.
He's a white man.
No, he's Cuban. That was his thing.
He's a white guy with a drinking problem, which is fine. I don't think there's such thing as a drinking problem. The problem is you don't have enough cold ones.
Yeah, that's the only real drinking problem, is not having enough to drink. But Razor Ramon, he was all about, he was machismo chico, remember?
Nah, obviously I love Razor Ramon. I love Scott Hall, and Scott Hall's done wonders to, you know, for his health.
For my career.
Yeah. Is Scott Hall one of my favorite? You know what? He's definitely one of my favorite fake Cubans. I'll give him that.
Yeah.
I just don't like him recently. because it seems like he's abandoned the drinking and now he's doing yoga.
Yeah.
Well, what's pretty... one bad advice for another?
Yeah. Yeah, you know what? That's a good point. Now he's always just saying, hey, man, I'm proud of my son.
Yeah. Like a nerd. Yeah, that's some nerd shit, brother. Well, come on. Sure
your son's a jamoke.
He's the least memorable Bullet Club member.
Wow, and that's saying something.
Yeah. In a world with Mr. Juicy, you are the least memorable member.
Or Bone Soldier.
Bone Soldier, fuck. Got a mask and everything. Get the fuck out of here. I remember Bone Soldier. I don't remember your fucking tall son's ass. Next question.
Yeah.
Speed Elvis. Round. From some star stuff here.
Triple S. Like Triple H.
Yeah. You were talking about Triple H's butt the other day. I saw that.
Oh, yeah. Me and The Undertaker were talking about it a little bit. Undertaker, that guy's pretty uptight, man. I like him.
You like him a lot. He's a good influence on you.
Yeah, he's keeping me honest.
Some star stuff is asking us. Mariah Carey. This is a speed round. Okay. Mariah Carey or Rihanna?
Mariah Carey in a wash. Easy. Yeah.
Mimi, come on. Yeah, it's not even close. It's not even close. Rihanna, okay, she burned Kevin Durant pretty good too, but she's no Mimi.
She likes to party. I think she would probably, you know what? Actually, she would like us way less than Mariah Carey would like us. Mariah Carey would be like, oh, you
Mariah Carey's, but Mariah Carey embraced that diva aspect. Like, oh, she's such a diva. And she owned it and said, yeah, because I'm fucking good at what I do. Why wouldn't I be a diva? I was in the Zohan movie.
I once saw something on MTV and it was about what musical stars demand are in their dressing rooms when they play live shows. And she demands an entire room just filled with stuffed lambs, like little stuffed animals of lambs.
Right, right. And Britney's like, I need all the green, sexy M&Ms, please.
Yeah, I don't know about that. Van Halen, they needed all of the green M&Ms taken out, I think.
Weird. That was convenient. Get them to Britney.
I mean, you would always want somebody picking through all of your M&Ms before you eat them.
Duh. Why wouldn't you? Yeah. All right. So, the next one. Okay, we shouldn't take so long on each one either. Nissan or Hyundai?
Nissan.
Hyundai, easily. Have a Sonata, for fuck's sakes, man. It's great. It's a great ride. Served me well during the Clone Wars.
Yeah.
All right. Mac and cheese or lasagna?
Lasagna, brother. Real cheese, move in silence.
Mac and cheese. For the love of God, dude. It's so much better. Lasagna is too much. Oh, there's lasagna layers.
Vegetables in it. That's good for you.
Ugh. Ugh. You I'm going to be sick.
You make me sick. I'd rather have layers. I'd rather have structure to my food than just a massive goo.
Cheese is good for you. It's orangey.
Yeah, there's cheese in lasagna too. And there's structure to it. Sugar structure? Ray. Structure? Yes.
Fuck you.
The timing and structure. Did you hear? Sugar Ray versus Los Lonely Boy. Sugar Ray. Come on, Mark.
That's not even a question. Sugar Ray. Sugar now, Ray, man.
Here's a good question. Milano cookies versus Chips Ahoy.
This is the toughest one that she posted.
It is, because what about Chewy Chips Ahoy? But she didn't mention it.
I don't like Chewy Chips Ahoy. They feel like they got soggy.
No, I like that.
I don't like that. I don't like Chewy Chips Ahoy.
I like a little squish to my food, brother.
No, I don't, you know, if they had introduced regular Chips Ahoy, if they introduced them at the same time, it'd be different, but no, I like Chips Ahoy a lot, but Milano cookies are such good quality. But you know what? I've thought about this a lot.
Yeah.
I'm going to go with Chips Ahoy despite the high quality because it's just easier to keep going through more of them. And Milano's, after a while, you're a bit tuckered out.
No, this is what I like. We're getting back to the lasagna thing. There's layers involved in Milano's.
Milano's is like, look, I don't give a fuck about lasagna. I'm not going to fight. You know, fight you on Milano's. Milano's are like a little sandwich.
Yeah, damn. Lasagna is like a sandwich of pasta. Now here's
yeah, it's too fucking much,
brother. You're getting me mad and pissed off.
It's too much. It's like unnecessary, man. It's like It's like deep again. It's like my qualms of deep dish pizza.
It's like what a king. It's like what a king would eat. A mighty.
No, it's not what a king wouldn't eat. That
a king would feast upon a lasagna.
No, because it's the same thing over and over and over.
You're the same thing over and over and over. The Matrix versus The Matrix Reloaded.
Fuck you.
I never even saw The Matrix Reloaded.
Is that the second or the third one?
I don't know, man. I only ever saw the first one.
I like the Wachowski one. I'm telling Ivanka and Elon Musk.
Yeah, they eat shit.
Yeah, that was great. Yeah, I don't know which Wachowski sister it was, but
bravo. God bless both of them, as far as I'm concerned. Jorts versus swim shorts.
I don't like the netting and swim trunks.
Board shorts, though.
Board shorts are cool. I feel like I could see Michael Fassbender's dick outline through them, so I guess I'll go with board shorts.
He'd have to wear board pants to keep that dick hidden.
Yeah, all right.
All right.
Hell of a dick, Fassbender. You're not allowed to talk about it.
Yeah, hey, I feel like this is sexism.
This is kind of objectifying. Is this what women have been going through for hundreds of years?
Hey, guys, there's a lot more to me than my big dick that hangs down almost to my knees. All right, Zaps versus Lay Stacks. Lay Stacks, come on now. You know who you're dealing with?
I don't think anybody's bought Lay Stacks, like, intentionally.
I have. I always do. I put them down like Coca-Cola, brother.
Yeah, that's the wrong way to eat those.
I lift up the cap and I just take sips of it. I smash them up with a stick I shove down in there so they get all smashed and I just drink them down.
Yeah, that's disgusting. I don't know what Zaps are, but they have to be of a higher quality. So
they're these hipster potato chips.
And I'm not crazy about hipster potato chips necessarily. I'm not thrilled about them with the fancy packaging and all that. And sometimes they're less than, you know, your bag of Ruffles.
Yeah.
But I don't respect Lay's Stacks. I feel like I just chuck those. I would chuck them like Steve Austin did to The Rock's Intercontinental title.
Right into the river?
Right into the fucking river.
Damn, that's disrespectful. And then her last question is Corona versus a vaccine. Man, I'll always take a cold Corona over some dumb old medicine.
You want me to get a shot? No, thank you.
Yeah, I'll take a cold beer, though.
Yeah, I'll take a cold beer.
Hey. We've established coronavirus has never been found in a cold beer.
No, even the CDC recently said, now I feel like this is to work in accordance with the corrupt government, but the CDC said getting corona from like surfaces are very rare, which again, I feel like this is suspect to all of a sudden be saying 2 months in, I feel like this is like, hey, we got to get shit open. So just say this crap.
Yeah.
Yeah.
By the way, actually getting coronavirus makes your dick turn into Fassbender.
Yeah. One side effect of coronavirus. Oh, you get a case of the Fassbender dick.
Yeah. Oh, man. I would be out there just licking doorknobs. Here's a question, Franklin. Franklin, this one is a hot seat one. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
It's from Rounding Down, which is a podcast which is sentient and is not hosted by any humans. It says, I got a question for you. Why is Franklin dodging Rounding Down? Is he afraid of the hot seat? Show's okay, which I guess he means their show. Their show is okay. It's fine.
I got to go on. I owe it to them. I feel like it's just something that just gets, you know, like, oh, we forgot. Or, you know, I feel bad. It just hasn't happened that I'm just like, I think there's maybe one time where I was like, oh, guys, turns out. There was definitely one time like I was like, oh, I'm tired of shit, you guys. I'm sorry. Like it was pretty basic like that. And we were never able to reschedule from there. And I do feel bad about that. I'll do it. I'll do it soon. I'll talk to them.
Make a pillow promise.
It's a pillow promise. I will be on Rounding Down.
I can't wait to listen to that episode.
Yeah. Yeah, you can listen to them on the Buzzcast Network.
On the Buzzcast Network. Check it out. Starring us. All right. Here's a question. Mike Regan, favorite opera overture. What does this mean? What is he asking us, Franklin?
Opera overture. I mean, it's like
Offers like fancy music, like Panama by Van Halen.
No. It's like John Will I Am from who does Star Wars.
Oh yeah, you are now rocking with John Will I Am and Darth Vader, bitch.
All right, let me play an opera overture for you. How about that?
So we get a. You know what's so cool when you see Darth Vader's helmet? And then it plays the doom, doom, doo, doo, and that sad movie I saw. Oh, that movie made me so sad.
Revenge of the Sith?
Yeah, I was crying, brother.
Yeah, you were blubbering. Let me play an opera overture.
When Obi-Wan says, I've got the high ground, he meant both morally and physically. That's good.
Okay. Hold on. No, they're playing me an ad here. YouTube, you sneaky bastards, you snuck in an ad here. I want to play a little bit. This opera is pretty cool. Let's see.
Yeah, you think that's cool?
Yeah, let me see. You don't like this?
This is opera, huh?
Yeah, it's cool.
Yeah, this is cool, man.
It's chill. Yeah. I feel like I'm getting smarter, more smarter.
Smarter, happier.
It's working. I'm getting more smarter as we speak. You know, the Dow Jones recently has gone up 17 kilo points.
Kilo points.
Yeah, opera's dope, dude. Yeah. Honest to God, opera. I'll fuck with opera.
Hey, that's not bad, man. But can I play my favorite opera overture?
Of course.
All right. Thank you, my friend. Hang on. Let me pull up my electric shoes CD.
It's not opera.
Oh, this is a moving song. That video you got Diamond Dave with no shirt on, and that ain't nothing wrong for me to see.
No, that's cool. Don't get me wrong.
He's like getting arrested. He's like, hey, no, don't take me away.
Next question.
Yeah.
This is a smart one. Fat Old Brian is asking it. The OG.
Yeah, Bizra.
Should we abolish
the
regular Oreo and make double stuff the standard?
No.
Yes.
No.
Eloquently said, Uncle Howard. Why are you so wrong?
Well, because as my other favorite band, The Doors, once sang, you know, the day destroys the night, night divides the day. Well, same about Oreos. You can never have a double stuff if you don't have a normal stuff. And if it's just a normal stuff, then eventually, even though it's a double stuff, you're going to say, man, I wish there was a double stuff, even though the normal is now the double stuff.
Wrong, and I'm gonna tell you why.
Oh, Max Kellerman.
I'll quote some other lyrics for you. Evolution is a mystery. Motor heads. And
Motoring.
Yeah. Evolution is a mystery. Yeah, we evolved. All right. We don't go back. We go forward as people. We go forward. We evolve. We get better. Our ideas improve. You know, are you driving a Maserati or are you going to go back to horseback? No. You're done?
Yeah, I'll get that.
I'll take it a step further, Fat Old Brian. Yes, we should abolish the regular Oreo. There's no need. Maybe put it in a museum. Maybe, you know, put it in a VH1 yesteryear documentary style type thing. That's fantastic, you know? Why we love the year 1991, you know? I don't know. I should take it a step further. We should get rid of cake. We already have ice cream cake. The pinnacle, the standard. Why don't we go back? Like the first thing when there's an office party. Oh, we got a cake. Okay, awesome. Is it an ice cream cake? That's the first question you ask. And they go, oh, no. And you know, it's like, oh, you know, I've had a lot of bad office cake, Uncle Howard. So I'm very sensitive to the subject. You know, I don't understand the need to experiment for an office birthday. Why you decide to take gambles and risks? I don't know. I feel like HR, they dropped the ball there.
No one in the office should know your birthday.
I concur with that.
Yeah, that is too close. That's too personal. You don't want those. A coworker is just an enemy that is waiting. That they're just all Anakins to your Obi-Wan.
A coworker is an enemy you just haven't made yet.
Yep, that's right.
That's some church right there. I won't front with that.
Yeah, that is damn true.
That's Iglesias.
This is from Ezreal at To Live and Die and NA. He says, Bug dropped an album. When's the U2U debut coming out?
Are we dropping an album? I mean, that's a great idea.
No, we're dropping an interactive experience.
Sure. We are, actually. Well, that's more a Bug Con. I mean...
Oh, I meant another one. For all senses.
Okay. Well, I'm sorry. I mean, we can't a U2 debut. I mean, I am already on Bugmain's album. So Uncle Howard, you're next to get, you know, you need a song. You need to get explore. You know, I am already an IMDb and I'll have a discography soon. Glad you're just
having
a great time with Motorin.
Motorin. So what do they say?
Next question.
Motorin. Yeah.
At Croat DF. That's like a day one almost. I got nothing but love for Croat DF.
Yeah, that stands for down as fuck. He just left out the A.
Yeah. A sad effect of the stay-at-home restrictions is I'm completely bored with masturbating. Any suggestions to spice it up?
Yeah, you got to get one of those Anakin arms.
That's right.
Or, hey, do you think General Grievous ever got bored of masturbating? He got all them arms, man.
You know, I got a solution. Or I should say sleeves has a solution. And that's more screens. Be like Dr. Claw and Inspector Gadget.
Yeah, Ulysses Claw.
That's right. Ulysses Claw from Black Panther 1.
From Avengers 2, The Rise of Ultron.
The James Spader?
Oh, yeah, James Spader. He was so handsome when he was young, and then he got older, and he lost all of it.
Isn't that weird?
He was Ultron. He's the, you know, look at Ted Danson, man. That guy stayed handsome.
I guess.
Oh, you don't think Ted Danson is
I get no, yeah. You're right. He stayed handsome.
What's wrong with you, pal?
What's wrong with me? What's wrong with him? What's wrong with him?
One of these days, you're going to be an old man, too. You're going to be not like, happening. Old man, look at my life.
Motherfucker, I won't pull what Ted Danson did.
You're not going to marry Mary Steenburgen?
No, well, stop playing with the knife, for starters, and... I am not going to do what he did with Whoopi.
Oh, you mean make a very tasteful Halloween costume?
Sure. Exactly that. Next question. I'm not going to do it. What was the question yet? The sleeves tweet.
Yeah.
More screens, please.
I say General Grievous arms.
General Grievous arms. I think we got all the questions. Well done, Uncle Howard.
Oh, he did.
Well, simply put, I wanted to do an hour. That's impossible for us. We just yap.
Hey, this was our closest to an hour we've ever done.
I guess. You know what? I think we're done here.
Wait, what's up? I have to warn you. I don't, but I feel somebody taking over my bone. Well, hey there, boys. It's me. It's Cajun Uncle Howard.
Oh, season 4, Uncle Howard. What the fuck?
Season 4, I've come here from the distant future to give you boys a little bit of a warning, no?
What's happening?
Well, before I get into the warning, I just want to talk about life down on the old bayou. Oh, we got them Cajun Nutra rats. Oh, we got them gators. We got them cottonmouths swimming around in the old cypress trees. Oh, but boy, we have a good time too. You know, we love to have a bit of a party down in Mardi Gras. Well, anyway, I'm here to give you boys a warning.
What's that?
Well, oh no, I'm getting sucked back. Oh,
well, you can quickly tell us the warning.
Oh, not me.
Oh,
that guy.
God damn it, Cajun Uncle Howard from the Big Easy.
He never dispenses with the pleasantries.
He likes to yap, yap, yap. You know what? If your name is Cajun Uncle Howard, I got a bit of advice for you. Simply put, go
sit
fuck
on
yourself. Yeah, sit on it.